Hey guys, in this video, let us get an introduction to Hibernate. Hibernate is an open source ORM object relational mapping framework which helps to save or persist the Java objects in the database. What is ORM? ORM is a technique which is used to map the Java objects to relational databases like Oracle, MySQL, SQL Server. Let me explain this with an example. Assume in your Java applications you are having an employee class, which is a Java bean. This has few instance variables like name, employee ID, and salary. Whenever you want to save the employee object to the database, then we can use Hibernate, which uses ORM technique. ORM is a technique which helps to map the Java objects to the database. That is, the employee class will be converted into employee table. The properties of the employee class or the instance variables of the employee class will be converted into columns in the employee table: name, employee ID, salary. And when you want to save the employee object, say for example, I am having one employee object, employee emp1 equal to new employee. Assuming I am having a parameterized constructor like name, ID and salary. This employee object will be converted into a row in the database table where name will be Ram, employee ID will be 1, salary will be 1000. So, ORM is a technique which helps to convert your Java class into a database table. The instance variables or the properties of the Java class will be converted into columns. And each employee object that you create will be converted into rows in the database table. So, this is ORM technique. Hibernate uses this technique to perform the operation of saving the Java objects into the database. Now, let me go back to the slide. So, here you can read, Hibernate allows to convert the Java objects into database table rows. Okay. Whenever you want to save data into the database, as a developer, you need to write programmatically certain things. That is, you will open the connection, create the prepared statement, set the data for the prepared statement, then execute the query, and also you need to handle all the exceptions that may occur in your application, maybe due to the connection or the authentication, username, password, or maybe due to the SQL query. But when you work with Hibernate, all these will be taken care by Hibernate. That is, Hibernate handles the work of opening a connection to the appropriate database. It will create the prepared statement. It will also execute the DML statements. That is, insert, delete, update, or DDL statements, altering the table, creating a table. All these internal details will be taken care by Hibernate. So, Hibernate generates the SQL queries automatically and it will perform the DML operations. And it will also take care of the exceptions. You don't have to create the appropriate exception handlers to capture the exception. Hibernate internally takes care of the exceptions also. All the exceptions that may occur in Hibernate are runtime exceptions. Next, one other important thing about Hibernate is, Hibernate helps to persist the Java classes with the Java terms like association, inheritance. What exactly is the meaning of it? Let me explain it with an example. Assume you are having two classes. One is employee and the other one is address. Employee has an instance of address. If you want to save the employee object and address object using JDBC, in that scenario, you will be creating two classes. One is an employee table and another one will be an address table. Then you use a primary key foreign key relationship so that address ID is stored in the employee table. When you are going to work with Hibernate, Hibernate will take care of all these relationships, that is employee having an instance of address using certain annotations. So you don't have the headache of creating a primary key or foreign key. You just have to add the specific annotations with the help of which Hibernate will understand that this address ID has to be added to the employee table. So you are not going to talk in terms of SQL when you are working with Hibernate. All the code that you are writing is Java centric. So similar to association, inheritance mapping also can be taken care with the help of Hibernate. Say you are having a superclass employee and subclass manager. In that scenario, whether you want to have it as two separate tables or as a joint table or one single table. So Hibernate supports mapping for association and inheritance, which is all Java terms. Where can we use Hibernate? Hibernate can be used in standalone Java applications. It can be used in enterprise applications or even in web applications. Now, let us see the basic architecture of Hibernate. So this is the Hibernate architecture. Here I have the Java application. In the backend, I have the database. This is the pictorial representation of Hibernate architecture. Before jumping into the Hibernate architecture, let us also see how we use JDBC to connect to the database. So here we have a Java application and the database in the backend. Now in between these two, we have the interface as JDBC API. Whenever we are using JDBC API to connect to the database, in our Java application, we have to programmatically write the details to connect to the database, that is opening the connection, what is the URL, the username, the password, to which database we are connecting, that is the database driver details, what is the dialect. Together with that, we will be writing the code to create the prepared statement, setting the data to the appropriate columns and then executing the query. So we will be writing all the SQL statements in our Java code, which internally is understood by JDBC API and persists the data in the database. Now coming to the Hibernate part. This is the Hibernate architecture. Here also we are having a Java application. The backend is the database. The intermediary is Hibernate. Hibernate internally uses the JDBC API to connect to the database. Already we have learned that Hibernate is responsible for establishing a connection to the database. How it is possible? We are going to use declarative configuration. Here you can see three things. One is persistent object, Hibernate CFG.xml and Hibernate mapping. The persistent object is the object that you want to save to the database. Maybe an employee object or a mobile object or an address object in our case. The next one is the Hibernate configuration file. So all the details that are relevant to connect to the database are given in the Hibernate configuration file. The name of the Hibernate configuration file is hibernate.cfg.xml. The details that are relevant to the database like URL, username, password, the dialect, the driver name is given in the Hibernate configuration file. The next one is the Hibernate mapping. When you are working with JDBC, you will set the values for the individual column. But in case of Hibernate, we are converting our Java class into the database table, our instance variables to the appropriate columns. Each Java object will be converted into a row. So all those information has to be given in the mapping document. The mapping document can be in the form of XML or annotations. XML is very old, it is outdated, so we will be using annotations. The annotation specifies what should be the column name, what should be the length of the column, which one is the ID, what should be the table name. So though all those informations that are relevant to the mapping is given with the help of annotations. And the configuration file can be in the form of XML or it can be properties. Now, let us see the advantages of Hibernate. When you work with Hibernate, establishing a connection with the database, opening a connection, creating a prepared statement, setting the values, executing the DML statements, handling the exception, all these are taken care. That is the internal operations of generating the SQL statements are taken care by Hibernate. Declaratively, you need to specify the details that is needed for Hibernate to connect to the database. That is done with the help of the configuration file. So due to this, the code is minimized in Hibernate. The number of lines of code that you write in your program is totally minimized. The next advantage is metadata control persistence. You are not going to write anything programmatically. You will be using simple methods of Hibernate only. Rest of the details, that is the database details, are given in the form of configuration XML, and the mapping details are given in the form of annotations. That is given over here. The details to connect to the database is given in the form of XML. The mappings are given in the form of XML or annotations. We will be talking only about annotations. The mapping language is also Java centric. That is, all the annotations, whatever you are writing, are specific to Java, not specific to the database. The next advantage is pooling, caching, transactions. All these are taken care declaratively. None of them are written in our code. They are not written programmatically. You will be handling the caching part, transaction part in your XML file only. Next, suppose say if you want to write advanced queries, in that scenario, you are not going to use SQL, you are going to use HQL, Hibernate query language, which is completely Java centric. You will not be talking in terms of the database, rather you will be talking in terms of Java. All the HQL queries that you will be writing are Java specific, they are not SQL specific. So these are few advantages of Hibernate. Now let us see the advantages of Hibernate over JDBC. In case of JDBC, it is the developer's work to establish a connection, create prepared statement, execute the DML statements. That is, programmatically you will be writing all as Java code. In case of Hibernate, Hibernate handles all these. So due to this, the number of lines of code that you write in Hibernate is completely reduced. In JDBC, the SQL queries are given directly. That is, if you want to insert a particular row in the database, then explicitly you write the query as insert into table name values. Say for example, employee values. And you have to set the values for this employee table. When you are working with Hibernate, the code is Java centric. That is, you will be using Java methods from Hibernate to perform the DML operations. Say for example, if you want to insert a Java object into the database table, you will use a simple method called as save, and you will pass the employee object, that is the Java object. This will internally create the insert statement to insert this object into the appropriate columns. Similarly, if you want to delete a particular row from the database table, in case of JDBC, you need to write the delete query. In case of Hibernate, you will be simply calling the delete method. Similarly, if you want to retrieve a row based on the ID, then you will write the query as select star from table name where ID equal to question mark. In case of Hibernate, you will use one simple method called as get, which will retrieve one particular row based on the ID. So, in case of Hibernate, you will be using only Java methods to connect to the database. Hibernate will internally convert these Java methods into SQL statements. Hibernate uses only prepared statement. The next difference is, when we work with multiple tables in JDBC, it is the developer's responsibility to establish a proper foreign key primary key relationship and also the join query part. But in case of Hibernate, already we have seen that Hibernate supports Java terms like association and inheritance. There are few annotations with the help of which we can establish the primary key foreign key relationship. Based on the annotations that you have given, Hibernate will create the tables and establish the appropriate relationship between the tables. So these are few advantages of Hibernate over JDBC. So this is all about an introduction to Hibernate.